Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Alexis. Thanks for tuning in. So, today we will be continuing my series, Music Inspires My Makeup. If you haven't got the chance yet, go check out the other two episodes I did. It's been a minute since I've done one of these, but I was just really feeling it today. So, today we will be throwing it back a little bit to the 1975 song, The Sound. Now, this was from their album Many Moons Ago. I Like It How You Sleep, for you are so beautiful yet so unaware of it. And although it's old, I just really love this song, and I just want to explain to you my little look here because it ties into the makeup look. So I just want to explain to you the look I have on because it ties in with the makeup look. So obviously I have the 1975 shirt. I think this came out like circa A Brief Inquiry into Online Relations. Oh my god, my brain is hurting. When that album came out, this is when I got this shirt. I have these black and white plaid pants. And then we have this pink bandana. Come up a little closer. I have some studs in, and then these little dangly hearts, because obviously The Sound is about, like, I know the sound of your heart, so we have little hearts. And then I just wanted to top it off with this little necklace, just because, I don't know, I thought it was cute and added a little pop color. So, not color, but just like a little pop. I have the black and pink because I feel like The Sound was really their transition into more pop rather than alt. And fun little fact for you, I was listening to the song earlier, and in Genius's Behind the Lyrics, Maddie actually said that they had that song written before the first album came out, which was like 2013, and he felt like it was too pop for them at the moment, so that's why they put it on A Brief Inquiry.
No, oh my god.
I Like It How You Sleep.
When you sleep. Sorry, my brain is hurting today.
Anywho, so I'm wearing the black to symbolize the self-titled album, which was pretty like all and pretty dark, and pink because it's like transitioning into I Like It How You Sleep, which was more pop. And if you watch the Sound video, there is a lot of pink and just a lot of glitter and a lot of fun stuff going on. So that is what I will be doing today. Now I'm going to position you a little bit closer so you can see the makeup look, and let's get started. I will be starting off today with some makeup primer because obviously not to prime is a crime, as Miss Nikki Tutorial says. So here I have Arbonne's makeup primer. Quick little shout out. I am an independent consultant for Arbonne. My link is always in the description to browse my site. Feel free to check it out. I'm here if you have questions. This is some good stuff. So we're just gonna put that on real quick. Now that we have the face primer on, I'm gonna go right in with the eye primer. Today I'm just using e.l.f.'s eyeshadow primer. Alright, we are primed. I'm going to get my eyeshadow palette and we'll get right into this look. So today for the eyeshadow, we will be using Jeffree Star's Bloodlust palette. I feel a little weird using this with all the drama going on, but guys, I like this palette. Okay, this is some good makeup, so I'm just gonna use it. And we're gonna ignore who made it right now. Anyway, so we're just gonna start with a base. So I will be using Your Majesty right here, this white shade. Also, while I'm here, if you've listened to Notes on a Conditional Form, what's your favorite song? How do we feel? I've seen a lot of people that either hate the album or really love it. I really vibe with it, honestly. I like all the songs. I just like how especially with this album, they really brought in a lot of their old themes, like a lot of lyrics, a lot of sounds from their old albums, and I love that, because it's honestly, it's a story, it's not just like an album. Each time, there's like a continuing theme, and I love that about this album. So let me know what your favorite song off of Notes on a Conditional Form is. So, next up, we'll be going in with Royal Pain, this pink shade right here. I'll be just pushing that into the creases. Okie dokie, we have Royal Pain on the crease. I put some under my eye as well. Now moving on to the top coat of the eyeshadow. I'm going to be leaving this brush out just in case I need to do some touch-ups. So, as I was saying earlier, it was a very, very sparkly feeling that the sound was giving me, especially from that music video. Just very sparkly, very, I don't even know how to explain it, but I just want some glitter, BB! So, we will be doing Wet Jewel right on the lid. I will be using my finger because I feel like it applies better that way for me. You can use a brush if you want, whatever you want to do, it's up to you, boo. So we're going to be taking Wet Jewel and just putting it on the lid. Now you may be thinking, wow girl, that's glittery! And I'll tell you, not glittery enough, baby. I'm just gonna go in on top, with some highlight, make it really glow. So I just have the Anastasia Beverly Hills Dream Glow Kit right here. I'm just gonna take the shade Unicorn right there. I'm just gonna put that on my eye. Awesome sauce. Now, I'm just gonna brush away this excess glitter for now. Alright. I'm going to curl my eyelashes, and I will be doing some under eye black liner today. Just to kind of tie in, like, the... Oh, this is gonna sound so gross. But, like, the edginess of the first album, and then, like, the glitter and the pink will be for the second album. You know what I mean? You get my vibes. Also, I think in the music video, Maddie is actually wearing eyeliner on his bottom lid. So, let's just pay homage? I don't know how you say that word. Let's just, holy crow. Okay. Alright, we're gonna put some black liner on the bottom. So I'm just using this liner from Mally. I don't really know if that's how you say it. But I'm just gonna try to do this. So I have some eyeliner on the bottom lid. Now we're going to put some on the top. And I'm a little funky. I always use two eyeliners. I don't really know if it does any difference. But I'm just more comfortable doing it this way for some reason. Yet again, questionable person that made this, but I got it for free. So yes, I'm going to use it. So I'll be starting off with the Kat Von D tattoo liner. I'm going to attempt to do a wing. I'm not really sure how this is going to come out. I'm not that great at it. I'm still learning. Just so you guys know, I'm not a professional makeup artist. I just like doing it. Also, go follow my makeup account on Instagram, Alexis Rose, MUA. She will be linked down below. All right, let's try to wing. I mean, honestly, I'm not mad at it. Here, I'll come up a little bit closer so you can see. Obviously, it's not that dramatic of a wing. I wasn't really going for that. I think I would need like a felt tip liner to really get that kind of look, but here you have it. So I'm just going to go on top of that line I just drew with Girl, where am I putting my... Okay. With the Essence Super Last eyeliner in deep black. Next up is some... Oh my god. Okay. Is some primer. So, I have their Real by Benefit Cosmetics, the tinted primer for my eyelashes. Next on the list is mascara. Oh, where in the world did I put it? Okay, next up we have Speak Volumes Mascara by Arbonne. Yet again, I am a consultant. Check it out down below. I will say, now, disclaimer, I am a consultant. Take this with a grain of salt. This is my favorite mascara I've probably ever used. If you guys have been watching me for a while, every makeup routine I've done so far, I've had to use two mascaras to get the look I wanted. Recently, I was doing Better Than Sex Mascara by Too Faced Cosmetics and Man Eater by Tarte all in one. So I go, and it was chunky, gloopy, a mess. So when I finally tried this, I've been so happy that I don't have to use like more than one mascara. You feel me? It's just great. So there you go, guys. Check it out if you want. If not, totally fine. But yeah. Let me just stop. Cut the cameras. Dead ass. Mascara is done. Now it is a little bit messy, but don't you worry, don't you fret. We have Q-tips to clean it up, baby. So moving on to the face. I don't know what this is called. It's just some concealers and whatever. So I'm going to be using this little green color correcting one, putting it all over my pimples. Because y'all, quarantine has been stressful, as you probably know. So I've been breaking out here and there, a little bit of everywhere. So we're just gonna try to remove the presence of these little nuisances. Now I have been washing my face every day, don't worry, with my Arbonne skincare. I will be making a little skincare routine video probably soon. I'm not really sure yet, but keep an eye out for that. If you guys want to see that, let me know. So as you can tell, I'm just dabbing on this beauty. No, I'm dabbing on this stuff with a beauty blender. Amazing, perfect. Yeah. Alright, moving on to foundation. Now, I know you're supposed to use concealer before foundation. It just fell out. But I use it afterwards because I'm a psycho.
This is Alexis's studio?
Yeah? That's right, baby. Alright, so today I'll be using Clinique Beyond Perfecting Foundation in the shade 5 Light. I just kind of put it a little bit everywhere. Yet again, y'all, I don't really know if my method is the right method. I don't really think there is a right method when it comes to makeup, because in my opinion, makeup is an art form and you can do whatever the heck you want with it. So this is what I'm doing. And there you have it. I have this foundation on looking a little crazy.
Oh my god!
I'm going to be using a foundation brush right here and just going ham trying to blend this baddie in. So, we have our foundation on. I was gonna do my brows, but I'm not really feeling it, so I'm not going to. And though literally no one asked, I just figured I would tell ya. Alright, now we're going to do some concealer. Which I know is probably illegal that I'm doing it after foundation. But it's okay, it's whatever. So I'll be using e.l.f.
16, oh my god!
e.l.f. 16 Hour Camo Concealer in the shade Medium Peach. As you can tell, I'm kind of just blotting in my whole face just to like really make sure that foundation isn't like cakey and is blended out. everywhere. Okay. Now I'm going to use some setting powder. I have the e.l.f. Perfect Finish HD Powder. Oh my god, that is a little bit broken. So it's a little messy, but you know what? It's whatever. Next is bronzer. I have the Maybelline City Bronzer in the shade 300. Next up is blush. So, I will be using Tarte's Party shade. It's like P3A's RTY. So we're just gonna use a little bit of this. And then I'm also gonna go in with, oh no, okay. Hourglasses blush in the shade Ethereal Glow, because there is a little glowiness to it, and as we know, I've said it how many times now, it was quite glittery and sparkly in that video, so we just really want to get that sparkle, you know. So we're gonna take some of this. Moving on to highlight, I'm going to take that glow kit again. I will be using the shade Unicorn, that pink shade again. I'm actually going to wet my face first, just so that it's like extra glowy. And I'm really disappointed because I used to have this like liquid highlighter that was pink and like really pretty. I think I might have thrown it out many moons ago, and this would have been perfect for this video. Anyway, it's fine. So I'm just gonna use the e.l.f. makeup setting spray to set my face real quick. Hello? All right. Now take your brush and your highlight real quick before this dries. Take that shade, go right in, baby. And I really don't feel like you can go wrong with too much highlight, honestly. I just love it. It's probably my favorite part of my makeup routine, because we love highlight in this household. All right, now, oh my god, do you see all that fallout? Girl. All right, we're gonna take another layer of that setting spray, and I'm gonna go in on top with the shade Regal and the same glow kit. Beautiful, girl. And I always put some under my eyebrow, on my nose, and my cupid's bow. Glittery goddess. We love to see it, we really do. And I am going to go in. Oops. Oh my god. I'm gonna go in with the shade Unicorn and put it in my inner corners. Just to really get that pop. It's popping. Beautiful. All right. I'm going to find a lip shade to wear and we'll be right back. We're almost done. Well, you might see some swatches in my hands. I was trying to decide which one I wanted to go with. God, another questionable person, but I just like their makeup. Please don't come for me. This is all stuff that I've just had. I haven't really bought anything recently, so I'm sorry. But we're going with On Wednesday. On Wednesdays by Kylie Cosmetics. Okie dokie, artichokey. So as I let this dry, I'm going to wash off these swatches. And then I think I might put a glitter on top of this just because, say it with me y'all, that video had a lot of glitter, a lot of sparkles, so let's get it. It's a little bit stained, but it's okay. So I've decided to go with Too Faced Melted Metal Liquified Metallic Lipstick in the shade Melted Metallic Peony. So I'm just gonna go right on top of the lipstick, a little dab of this gloss. I know. Alright, last but not least, we're gonna go in with one final layer of setting spray. Okie dokie. Ow. Keep hitting everything. There you guys have it. That is the final look. I will insert some pictures here so you can get a real sense of how it came out. I really hope you guys liked this video. I know I enjoyed making it. If you did, please, please, please subscribe. Hit that notification bell if you want. Give this video a like. Check out all the other videos in the series so far. I will have them linked down below. Thank you guys so, so much for watching. I'm going to try to put the songs in this video, but if it gets copywritten, go ahead and check out the songs. Check out the 1975's new album, A Notes on a Condition. Jeez! Notes on a Conditional Form. If you get this far, let me know in the comments which album is your favorite. I'm honestly leaning towards Notes on a Conditional Form. Thank you guys so, so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Go ahead, check out all the links in the description. I have some important links there for you. Keep an eye out on this channel. I have a fun series coming up that I'm very excited for. I hope you guys enjoy it. Thank you for being here. I will see you in the next video.